Good evening, love, marriage and even a baby. Gladys Berejiklian's ex-partner has spilled the beans about their secret relationship during his sensational evidence at the corruption watchdog. The most intimate secrets of the most private former premier were aired in public today by Daryl Maguire.
Daryl Maguire in the box, ready to kiss and tell.
Good morning, Commissioner.
But just before he dished the dirt, Gladys Berejiklian's lawyer tried to put a stop to the whole thing.
There is no public purpose served by plumbing the depths of the private life of my client.
But ICAC would not spare her the embarrassment, arguing the nature of their relationship is crucial to the inquiry and, according to Maguire, the partnership was deadly serious.
You and I both used the phrase close personal relationship, or in your case, very close personal relationship. I take it that that included a close emotional attachment?
Yes, we had our moments, but yes.
You loved her?
Yes.
And he said the feeling was mutual.
So far as you could ascertain, she loved you as well?
Yes.
You holidayed together from time to time?
Yes.
Get a key to her house?
Yes.
And then a bombshell. They talked about taking their relationship to the next level, a wedding and kids.
You contemplated marriage?
Yes.
With her?
Yes.
There was discussion about potentially having a child?
Yes.
It was a relationship, I take it, that was attended by a level of physical intimacy?
Later, yes, that's correct.
From his private life to his dodgy business deals, Maguire opened up to all of it.
Used your position as a Member of Parliament to gain benefits for you and persons close to you, correct?
Yes.
Admitting he did everything he could to get projects in Wagga funded.
I think the term was pain in the ass. Yes.
You're prepared to adopt the pain in the ass term, is that right?
Yes.
You were being a serial pest both to Minister Ayres and to Treasurer Berejiklian associated with that project.
Yes, every minister. That's true.
Maguire conceding he privately lobbied his then-girlfriend.
I would have encouraged her to take a close interest in it, yes.
Encouragement we got to hear firsthand thanks to a phone tap.
Keep listening to me and it'll be like the blazing star of the southern universe, I tell you.
Well, Wagga's just going to be like Sydney.
Correct. That's why we need a stadium. That's why we need a conservatorium. Stuart's talking about putting one in Dubbo and somewhere else and somewhere else. Them. Wagga's where it's going to happen.
Even Gladys Berejiklian seemed frustrated at his never-ending Wagga wish list.
Yeah. We ticked off your conservatorium the other day, so that's a done deal now.
Yeah, but that's only that's the building and $10 million, not the rest of it. Not the next
Oh, my
day.
God. Heaven help us, seriously.
But the former premier did not end the relationship when ICAC exposed his dodgy dealings back in 2018. And when he quit Parliament, Maguire even helped her with the by-election.
You've already told me the three top things.
And you need to go and give them a stadium. Give them a
stadium. I'll do that.
A stadium.
I'll do that too. I'll do that too. Don't worry.
Well, the bureaucrats knocked it all out.
Yes, but I can overrule them.
Gladys Berejiklian making it clear she will use taxpayer money to win the seat, also known as a pork barrel.
I just need to go and chill because you've stressed me out.
All right, I'll go and chill. You just throw money at Wagga.
I'll throw money at Wagga. Don't you worry about that.
Just listen
lots
to me.
Of it.
ICAC also tabled evidence that showed Gladys Berejiklian has publicly said in the past that she was in love with Daryl Maguire, evidence which matches Maguire's version today, but is completely at odds with what she told the Commission last year.
Effectively, that it was nothing serious.
You never met any member of Miss Berejiklian's family?
Not officially. No, I'd never been to the family home nor officially met the parents.
She was not introduced to your family, for instance, as Daryl's girlfriend?
No.
All of this is crucial as to whether or not Gladys Berejiklian was bound to declare the relationship. But whatever it was, it has ruined her career. Chris O'Keefe, Nine News.
OK, live to State Politics reporter Liz Daniels on Macquarie Street. Liz, the former Premier facing a tough day in the stand tomorrow.
And then some, Pete. Today would have been humiliating for Gladys Berejiklian, but she was able to endure it in private. Tomorrow, it will be all eyes on her. Her relationship, her secrecy, her perceived conflict of interest will all come under questioning. Pete, she has already lost her prized job, and now the former Premier only has her reputation to protect.
OK, Liz Daniels, thank you.